Hello, I'm Mr. R. Niger, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism and real Islam of Allah, not of Mullah. So what you're seeing in the Middle East or all over the world is very, very interesting. And those people who know gospel, they have nothing to worry. But most people, they are ignorant of gospel. Whatever their dog-collar priest or mullahs and other people tell them, you know, they just go by them. Gospel doesn't come from these people. They are anti-Christ. They're all exploiting people in the name of religion. And that is why it has got a very, very bad name. People have turned atheist, but that is not the solution. Solution is to know the cause. Gospel, this is the age of gospel, this dark age. The light is gospel. You have to get the gospel. Nobody is going to get it for you. If you don't get it, and if you suffer, then you yourself have to be blamed, not a third person. Take for example, you know, in 1947, partition of India, that was created by the British hypocrites. And then there were Indian hypocrites, Lala Gandhi, Lala Tara Singh Malhotra Khatri, and Lala Muhammad Ali Jinnah. So all these business people, they broke the India into two. And then the British shopkeepers, they said, you know, you made us win World War II. Now, when you fight with each other, we know you are a good soldier. When you fight with each other, we will supply you weapons and we will see how good you are at fighting. And that is what in Indo-Pak War, we people of Jat tribe, I'm Jat tribe, Marshall tribe, we fought with each other. People of the same tribe. And these are, we Jat people made them to win the war. And that is the reward we get. So this is a word of hypocrisy. So you have to enlighten yourself and enlighten those people among whom you are living. And then you are safe. Nobody can touch you. But if you are not enlightened and you are blind, then the blind, these mullahs and these dog-collar priests and all these people who put on robes in one form or the other, they will lead you to sectarian riots. They are very sweet-spoken. You trust them, but they are not worth trusting. To get rid of these dog-collar priests as a middleman between man and God, Jesus gave his own sacrifice. Jesus, not Christ. Jesus died on the cross, not Christ. Christ was in the beginning, is forever. Christ is a title. So Christ is never born, never died. Jesus was born, Jesus died. So he gave his own sacrifice, Lamb of God, to get rid of those rabbis who were putting yoke on the people. But soon after his death, these messianic Jews who were in the temple, arid spirit, they occupied the church of God. As stated in Matthew 12, verse 43 to 45, the arid spirit sect temple priest could not find a good job. They were useless, you know. So they said, oh, let's go back to our old customers in the Church of God. So they joined the Church of God and they bring Torah with them as bait. Torah is deadly poison to the New Testament because everything what is written in Torah, you need it, is all been proclaimed by Christ Jesus. So they bring this bait and they attracted the old customer, made the Church of God full of men of letters. All that, then they said, oh, let's get priests back, you know, like rabbis. They got these dog-colored priests and robed one, and they called them fathers, as they used to call to the rabbis. So in short, you know, they have just replaced the temple high priest with Pope. And you know how Pope killed people? And you are still deaf and dumb. You don't learn a lesson from him, you know. So when they start killing people, then Muhammad took a stick and showed you how to behave. So this Islam of Muhammad was of Mullah, Moon. Moon stand for Mullah. Allah is Sun, primary source of light. So this Mullahs created havoc in India especially. And that is why the second coming of Jesus in the name of Nanak took place. And so was the second coming of the Prophet. You know, there were two prophets in the Middle East, John the Baptist and Christ Jesus. John the Baptist was an ideal rabbi, Prophet Elijah. Christ Jesus came to preach gospel to the sons of man. And in India, we have two, Christ, Nanak, replacement of Jesus. And then we have Royal King Gobind Rai, who was the royal king of the royal kingdom of God, where justice prevails. So he organized sword power to get rid of those people who were doing atrocities over people. And that atrocities was worse than those in the Middle East. In the Middle East, you have princes of darkness. In India, we had the kings and emperors of darkness. Judas Iscariot was a prince of darkness. People of Khatri tribe in the Punjab, they are kings and emperors of darkness. So you can see how the people were suffering at this. Will carry on, you know, till the end of the world. Atomic war is not far away. It's written in the Bible, Matthew 13, verse 24 to 30. When end of the world come, I will bundle up the tares and burn them. Hardly anyone knows what is a tare, never mind knowing wheat plant. So, only the wheat plants will be saved, while the tares will burn like unquenching fire. As Jesus said, he has the winnowing fork in his hand. Grains, he will put it in the barn of our Father. Grains are sons of man, turned sons of God. Whereas the chaff, tares, and all that thing, they will be burnt with the unquenching fire. So this sectarian riots, you will see how people will kill each other like unquenching fire in thousands. You can't blame a third person. You have to blame yourself. Light came. It is your duty to seek light, not the duty of your dog-collar priest who are hireling. Mullahs looking for their own praises. So they are antichrist. Anybody who stands between man and God is antichrist. I put a couple of charts on my website and in description that will be very helpful. This is the one on the Son of Man versus Son of God. You will see that in Adam, you know, or in Yahweh, we are born and die, flesh, all flesh. Yahweh created Adam, Eve, and all that family here. The man represents the seed of Adam, whereas the woman represents our father, God. Blood comes from woman, semen comes from the man. Semen has the seed. We have ideal family in Middle East of Abraham. He had promised land, and so far his sons were faithful to Abraham. They enjoyed the best fruit of the world. So to make them sons, he established a covenant of circumcision. That circumcision was done only to Isaac and not to Ishmael, because that boy was of a slave woman. That is why slave woman, Hagar, and Ishmael was taken outside the boundary of the promised land, because slaves are not allowed to enter the house. So they were established there by Abraham. They were not thrown away. Abraham was a noble man. You can't expect anything like that from him. So he established them there, and the promised land was of Isaac and his seed. His seed was known by circumcision. I lived in Ghana 14 years, and over there people have tribal mark on their faces. Each tribe has its own mark. So by the tribal mark you can recognize that this man come from this tribe, Hausa, Frafra, Ashanti, all that tribe you can find from their tribal mark specific. That is to identify the people that they belong to certain tribe, to make them the sons of a man, tribal elders. So same tribal mark is of Abraham to Isaac, which is circumcision. Circumcision is nothing else but tribal mark. People are from India and from Africa, you know, and all those places which are not the seed of Isaac. You can see how they do circumcision, tend to be sons of Abraham. You can't become sons of Abraham like that unless you are born of the semen of sons of Abraham. A woman has no seed. A woman cannot be anything except counterpart of God in the production, reproduction. So there is a lot of misunderstanding, and religion has become the opium for the masses. With the result, people will die like flies, and they will be crying, you know, why we are dying? Because they did not understand the gospel. They did not care to look into the gospel. They just depended upon their mullahs, this and that. So one who will go for the gospel is 1 in 1,000 and 2 in 10,000, very few. So here it is. Then all that, you know, this side, which is of God, you have all the spiritual self. A Jew is one who is inwardly, not outwardly. This is outwardly, Adam. A Jew cannot be here. Jew is here. Spiritual, Sikh, Hindu, Muslim, Christian, all the spiritual selves, Shia, Sunni, all come under here. Never born, never die. So who is dying then? These people, they say, Shia fighting with Sunni. They are fanatic, tears, unfaithful to their tribal fathers. Politics is tribal affair. Afghanistan belonged to people of Afghan tribe, Balochistan to Baloch tribe. So countries belong to the tribal people and not to the religious selves. German belonged to German, Germany belonged to German tribe. Whenever these people had this strong tribal instinct, they killed Jews. When England was in England, when English were English and not Labour and Conservative, they killed Jews. When the German became German and not Conservative, Socialist and all that, they killed Jews in Holocaust. This is norm, nothing abnormal. So, this is one graph you should try to understand. And the other one is about the arrival of Jesus, where we stand in Jesus. This is a God, and Jesus came here, the primary source of light. Light. John the Baptist came here, ideal rabbi, moon and star. Moon stands for rabbi and star for angels. So here we have the angels, you know, and all that, and sons of man. And here we have sons of God, saint who preach gospel. Not these dog-colored people. Nobody can stand between man and God. That's why the curtain of the holiest of holy was torn apart from top to bottom, from top chief rabbi in the temple to the bottom in village rabbi. Out you go. So where from these dog-collar priests come up? They're all antichrist, corruption. The messianic Jews, they corrupted the Old Testament, they corrupted the New Testament. And now they are getting bundled up in Israel for final burning. Matthew 13, verse 24 to 30 is taking shape. So you won't find any peace in Middle East. Palestinians, they also are forgotten their tribal identity. Fatah, all these religious, you know, names you come across in political affairs, they are all sons of Satan. Palestinians, they are known by their tribe, not by Al-Qaeda, Fatah and all that thing, you know. Same Jews are known by their tribe. That's why in the Revelation, 144,000 that would be saved, they are all mentioned by their tribes, not Jews. So all these people who are break their covenant with the tribal elders, they will finish, because this planet Earth is for the sun, for the habitation of Adam and his sons, and not for Hindu, Sikh, Muslim, Christian, Jew, etc. No, no spiritual self. They are fanatic. And this fanatic, they are, I show them in the Hajj rite, and which is another video which you can find on my website, Hajj. So you have four types of Satan, and they are represented by three pillars. This is Ajmar al-Dunya, bastard born of the prostitutes. And these are the ones who change their tribal identity to suit their situation, greedy people. Ajmar al-Wusta. This is the Ajmar al-Aqsa, leaning against a mountain of fanatic. Shia, Sunni, all these I come here, Hindu, Sikh, Muslim, Christian, Conservative, Labour, all come here. It has two names, Ajmar al-Kubra and Ajmar al-Aqsa. When the people are exploited in the name of religion, then is Ajmar al-Aqsa. So first day of Hajj, people throw salmon stone onto this Ajmar al-Aqsa, Satan. And next day they throw seven on each for 3 days. In total they throw 70 stones. Now this is just intro. I put a lot of videos on Hajj and explaining everything in detail. So if you want peace, then you have to make effort yourself. I can help you. If you invite me to give a lecture, I can come and give you a lecture. And what I'm telling you is a practicum. During partition, 2,000 people came to attack our village. When we said, is the tribal people going to fight and kill each other? We asked them, if you have any enmity against our tribe, let us fight. The headman of the attacking party said, no, we are friends. So he gathered all the 2,000 people, told them, we people are their friends and we are their guest. So they treated us like guest. So instead of any killing or anything taking place or hatred, they loved us. So this is the power of gospel. You too can preach gospel, but it's up to you to seek gospel. Nobody can give you. You long for it and you will get it. Our Father God bless you. Remember that Allah, the word Allah is from Illah. Illah are the tribal gods. They used to be in Kaaba. And Kaaba is a temple of Adam. Nothing to do with God, Allah. So, from tribal father, Illah, which is our, each one has his own tribal father, which is not real. Our real father is Allah. Al-Illah, the father, Allah, spiritual. So that's where the Allah is a sun, not moon and star. So you can see mosque, you know, having moon, crescent, nothing to do with Islam. The real Islam is Sharia free, because Allah is Sharia free. If Sharia comes from Allah, then Allah will be bound by that Sharia, otherwise he will be a hypocrite. So he is not bound by any. He has free will, he is a free man. So wake up. And those people, you know, there are these people who are mullahs in the mosque and other things, ask them where from they come. If they are coming from Kashmir, Kashmir is the epicenter of the kings and emperors of darkness. So they are the number one Satan in the world. And you have to be careful of them. They will let you down proper. So gospel is there. It's up to you to accept it or to reject it. If you seek gospel, then you will live in peace with your neighbor everywhere. You won't kill each other. You will survive. But otherwise, the Islam of Mullah from Kashmir, are number one sons of Satan. So always ask these mullahs from Middle East, they are good people. And it is only these mullahs from India, Pakistan, they are creating havoc in the whole world. Our Father God bless you.